गुड मॉर्निंग चिल्ड्रन. सो दिस इज पार्ट टू ऑफ द वीडियो ऑफ द लेसन यूरेका इन लिटरेचर रीडर बाय द फेमस राइटर जेम्स बॉल्डविन. इन द प्रीवियस पीपीटी वी हैव ऑलरेडी गिवन यू द इंट्रोडक्शन अबाउट द राइटर एंड इंट्रोडक्शन टू द स्टोरी एंड वी ऑल्सो डिस्कस अबाउट सम ग्रेट इन्वेंटर्स एंड देयर इन्वेंशंस एंड सम लेजेंड्स बेस्ड ऑन द लाइव्स ऑल्सो. Now in this PPT, the detailed explanation of the story and the different elements in the story also will be discussed and about Archimedes' principle also. So coming to the textbook, now I assume that you have read the text, you have read the story. The setting is in the kingdom of Syracuse and the king. Characters there are, if you have come across, like, you know, you can see like there are three important characters: the king of Syracuse, that is Hero, and the wise man in his kingdom, in his court, that is Archimedes, and a goldsmith also. Now the plot, which is called the summary of the story, because these elements we already know, we have already learned it in Rip Van Winkle also, like what are the set elements of a story. So now I'm not going to explain each and everything in detail, because we have already done it in all the other lessons also. Plot, which is a story. So now in the story we can see, like, the story begins in the court of Syracuse, whose then the king's name is Hiero, and the country, the kingdom of Syracuse is very small only, but for that very reason itself the king Hiero wanted to wear the biggest crown in the world. For that he called all the goldsmiths, and he actually calls one of the famous goldsmiths in that city, who is very professional in this field, and he gives him 10 pounds of pure gold, and then he tells him to change this gold into a crown, and it should be so good that every other king should wish for such a crown. Okay, and at the same time he also asked him to make use of each and every grain of gold that he has given, and ask him not to mix it with any other metals. And goldsmith promises him, like, that I'm taking this 10 pounds of pure gold from him, within 90 days I'll be making such a beautiful crown for you using all the gold that you have given me, and it will be of the exact weight. Now the story takes place after 90 days, when he returns to the court with the gold crown that he has made, and it was such a beautiful piece of work, and whoever has seen it said that, you know, it is such a, has praised for the beauty. And actually it was not at all comfortable to wear that crown also. Still Syracuse, the hero, wore that crown thinking, like, you know, because it was such a fine headpiece. Then after he had admired it from his side, he weighed it on his own scales, like in the weighing machine, and he found that it was exactly as 10 pounds that he had ordered. Now comes our hero, that is Archimedes. Now in that court there lived a wise man also, whose name was Archimedes. And when king showed this crown to Archimedes, he tells him, like, you know, the skill, the design and everything is good, but Archimedes had a doubt regarding the weight of the gold. Okay, but the king was sure, like, and the king tells him, like, I have already measured it in my own scale and it is correct only. But then he tells him, like, he has got a doubt in the color, when he tells him, like, the actual have the same, it does not appear to have the same rich, the lump that he has provided, it was very red in color, but now it is fine yellow. Most gold is yellow, that was Hero's reply. But again, the more he thought about the this thing only, he was also in a dilemma, he was also confused. And then he asks Archimedes, is there any way to see that the goldsmith was honest? But and Archimedes says, like, you know, I know of no way. But Archimedes was such a kind of person who believed that nothing was impossible. So he took, because he loved, he worked hard in order to solve puzzles, hard problems and everything. He kept studying until he found an answer to it. Day after day, he thought about the goal and tried to find some way by which it could be tested without doing harm to the crumb. Then comes the next part of the story. While he was taking bath, till the edge of the tub, the water was filled, and the great then and he stepped into it. The quantity of water flowed out upon the same floor. And similar thing actually happened many times before also. That was the first time Archimedes had thought about it. Then he thinks like, you know, the amount of water that he displaced by getting into the tub, it will be equal to the bulk of his body. So because a man half of his size would be displacing half as much. Now he imagines like, if we put the crown into the tub, the amount of water that is displaced by that, it will be equal to its own bulk. But as gold is much heavier than silver, as gold's weight is heavier than silver, the 10 pounds of gold, because though I'm talking about the weight, the volume and the density of all the metals are different. So now Archimedes was able to determine, like, now he feels like, you know, Archimedes here thinks like he was able to determine that the crown was not pure gold. Okay, then he takes the crown of the king and he puts it into the water also, because he was thinks like the crown was not pure gold due to the volume of the displaced water. Okay, because even though the weight of the crown and the weight of the gold that the king gave the crown maker was identical to the weight of the gold that the king gave the crown maker, both of them were 10 pounds only, but the volume of the crown and the volume of the gold, it was different, by because of the various densities of the metals. Okay, so now just the moment he identifies the fact, he says Eureka, that is, I have found it, and then he leaves. Like, without stopping himself to dress, he ran through the streets to the king's palace shouting, Eureka, Eureka, Eureka. The crown was tested and it was found to displace more water than 10 pounds of gold, because the volume of gold and silver was different. And the guilt of the smith, it was proved without any doubt. Okay, then whether the king was punished or not, it is not told in the story. And but the Archimedes principle that he made, it is famous. Okay, so Archimedes principle states that the force on an object submerged in a fluid is equal to the weight of the fluid that is displaced by the object. So that is the Archimedes principle. So now you can see, like, after thinking long and hard about this, Archimedes was not, first he was not able to find a method for proving that the crown was not solid gold. Okay, now when he filled the bathtub and noticed that water spilled over the edge as he got in, and he realized that the water displaced by his body was equal to the weight of his body. Okay, knowing that the gold was heavier than the other metals, the crown maker could have substituted in. Okay, so Archimedes had his method to determine that the crown was not pure gold. So now, forgetting that he was undressed, he went running naked down the streets from his home to the king shouting Eureka. That's why the name of the lesson is also Eureka. Now I have explained it in detail in the previous slide. Now if you want to just get the summary, here is the summary also. So Eureka is a wonderful story of Archimedes and his greatest discovery. So his discovery is that Archimedes principle, that the amount of water that is displaced, it will be equal to the bulk of the thing that is put into that water. The king of Syracuse, Hero, wants to wear the biggest, the king of Syracuse, he was the king of the smallest kingdom, but because of that very reason itself, he wanted to wear the biggest crown in the world. He calls for his famous and skillful goldsmith, okay, who is an expert in his field, and he gives him 10 pounds of pure gold and orders him to make a crown and also tells him that no other metal should be added. He asks him to use the grain that he has provided to him and asks him not to use any other metal, and every grain of gold should be used to make it. So that is the his order. But the goldsmith also promises to return after 90 days, and after 90 days the goldsmith comes with a beautiful crown and the king is very delighted to see it. He weighs and finds it exactly as heavy as he had ordered, that is of 10 pounds only. So in the king's court there was a wise man called Archimedes, and the king shows the crown to him and asks about his opinion also. Archimedes examines the crown and replies, like, you know, it is very, like, you know, the design and everything is good. It is like, you know, the professionalism of the goldsmith can be seen in this. But he tells him, like, you know, it is not of pure gold. The reason that he gives is like the lump that he has given, it was rich red in color, but now it is of more yellowish. But some other metal has been mixed as its color seems different. The king asks him to find out if the goldsmith is honest or not. Archimedes was a person who never gave up things and took great delight in solving difficult problems. Now in this part of the story you can see, like, one fine morning while taking bath he notices that he displaces the amount of water that is equal to the size of his body when he takes a dip into the water tub. Then he thinks that the gold crown should also displace the amount of water equal to the volume, equal to its size. Finally, he concludes that since as gold is much heavier than silver, the 10 pounds of pure gold, it will not make so great a bulk as 7 pounds of gold mixed with 3 pounds of silver, because the volume of the different metals are different and thus the densities also will be different. Then he jumps out of the tub and he rushes to the court shouting, "Eureka, Eureka." He forgets to dress also, which means he has found it. And the crown is tested and it is like the same method that Archimedes had suggested, and it is found to displace more water than 10 pounds of pure gold can displace. Thus the goldsmith is proved guilty. Now this is Archimedes' principle, which is called law of buoyancy, that is, buoyant force is equal to the weight of the displaced fluid. You can ask your science teacher more about this buoyant force and everything. You'll be learning it in science gradually. Okay, thank you. Okay, so this is the second PPT in which we have already covered the reading of the textbook in detail and the summary of the story also and Archimedes' principle, and notes have already been uploaded in the channel. Please go through it. Thank you.